Chapter 23. So when David was old and full of days, he made Solomon his son king over Israel. And he gathered together all the princes of Israel, with the priests and the Levites. Now the Levites were numbered from the age of 30 years and upward, and their number by their polls, man by man, was 38,000. Of which, 24,000 were to set forward the work of the house of the Lord, and 6,000 were officers and judges, moreover 4,000 were porters, and 4,000 praised the Lord with the instruments which I made, said David, to praise therewith. And David divided them into courses among the sons of Levi, namely, Gershon, Kohath, and Merari. Of the Gershonites were, Ladan, and Shimei. The sons of Ladan, the chief was Jehiel, and Zetham, and Joel, 3. The sons of Shimei, Shalamith, and Haziel, and Haran, 3. These were the chief of the fathers of Ladan. And the sons of Shimei were, Hahut, Zina, and Jush, and Beria. These four were the sons of Shimei. And Hahut was the chief, and Ziza the second, but Jush and Beria had not many sons, therefore they were in one reckoning, according to their father's house. The sons of Kohath, Amram, Izhar, Hebron, and Utsiel, 4. The sons of Amram, Aaron and Moses, and Aaron was separated, that he should sanctify the most holy things, he and his sons forever, to burn incense before the Lord, to minister unto him, and to bless in his name forever. Now concerning Moses the man of God, his sons were named of the tribe of Levi. The sons of Moses were, Gershom, and Eliezer. Of the sons of Gershom, Shavuel was the chief. And the sons of Eliezer were, Rehabiah the chief. And Eliezer had none other sons, but the sons of Rehabiah were very many. Of the sons of Izhar, Shalamith the chief. Of the sons of Hebron, Jeriah the first, Amariah the second, Hahaziel the third, and Jechamim the fourth. Of the sons of Utsiel, Micha the first, and Jeziah the second. The sons of Merari, Mali, and Mushi. The sons of Mali, Eleazar, and Kish. And Eleazar died, and had no sons, but daughters, and their brethren the sons of Kish took them. The sons of Mushi, Mali, and Eder, and Jermoth, 3. These were the sons of Levi after the house of their fathers, even the chief of the fathers, as they were counted by number of names by their polls, that did the work for the service of the house of the Lord, from the age of 20 years and upward. For David said, The Lord God of Israel hath given rest unto his people, that they may dwell in Jerusalem for ever, and also unto the Levites, they shall no more carry the tabernacle, nor any vessels of it for the service thereof. For by the last words of David the Levites were numbered from 20 years old and above, because their office was to wait on the sons of Aaron for the service of the house of the Lord, in the courts, and in the chambers, and in the purifying of all holy things, and the work of the service of the house of God, both for the showbread, and for the fine flour for meat offering, and for the unleavened cakes, and for that which is baked in the pan, and for that which is fried, and for all manner of measure and size, and to stand every morning to thank and praise the Lord, and likewise at even, and to offer all burnt sacrifices unto the Lord in the Sabbaths, in the new moons, and on the set feasts, by number, according to the order commanded unto them, continually before the Lord, and that they should keep the charge of the tabernacle of the congregation, and the charge of the holy place, and the charge of the sons of Aaron their brethren, in the service of the house of the Lord. Chapter 24. Now these are the divisions of the sons of Aaron. The sons of Aaron, Nadab and Abihu, Eleazar and Ithamar. But Nadab and Abihu died before their father, and had no children, therefore Eleazar and Ithamar executed the priest's office. And David distributed them, both Zadok of the sons of Eleazar, and Ahimelech of the sons of Ithamar, according to their offices in their service. And there were more chief men found of the sons of Eleazar than of the sons of Ithamar, and thus were they divided. Among the sons of Eleazar there were 16 chief men of the house of their fathers, and 8 among the sons of Ithamar according to the house of their fathers. Thus were they divided by lot, one sort with another, for the governors of the sanctuary, and governors of the house of God, were of the sons of Eleazar, and of the sons of Ithamar. And Shemaiah the son of Nethaneel the scribe, one of the Levites, wrote them before the king, and the princes, and Zadok the priest, and Ahimelech the son of Abiathar, and before the chief of the fathers of the priests and Levites, one principal household being taken for Eleazar, and one taken for Ithamar. Now the first lot came forth to Jehoiarib, the second to Jedaiah, the third to Harim, the fourth to Sorim, the fifth to Malchijah, the sixth to Mijamin, the seventh to Hakaz, the eighth to Abijah, the ninth to Jeshua, the tenth to Shechaniah, the 11th to Eliashib, the 12th to Jochim, the 13th to Huppah, the 14th to Shabib, the 15th to Bilgah, the 16th to Immer, the 17th to Hezir, the 18th to Aphsaz, the 19th to Pethiah, the 20th to Jehezekel, the 21st to Jachin, the 22nd to Gemel, the 23rd to Delaiah, the 24th to Maaziah. These were the orderings of them in their service to come into the house of the Lord, according to their manner, under Aaron their father, as the Lord God of Israel had commanded him. And the rest of the sons of Levi were these: of the sons of Amram, Shubael; of the sons of Shubael, Jedaiah. Concerning Rehabiah, of the sons of Rehabiah, the first was Ishiah. Of the Izharites, Shalamith; of the sons of Shalamith, Hahat. And the sons of Hebron, Jeriah the first, Amariah the second, Hahaziel the third, Jechamim the fourth. Of the sons of Utziel, Micha; of the sons of Micha, Shamir. The brother of Micha was Ishiah; of the sons of Ishiah, Zechariah. The sons of Merari were Mali and Mushi; the sons of Jaziah, Bino. The sons of Merari by Jaziah, Bino, and Shoam, and Zachur, and Ibri. Of Mali came Eleazar, who had no sons. Concerning Kish, the son of Kish was Jeremiel. The sons also of Mushi, Mali, and Eder, and Jerimoth. These were the sons of the Levites after the house of their fathers. These likewise cast lots over against their brethren the sons of Aaron in the presence of David the king, and Zadok, and Ahimelech, and the chief of the fathers of the priests and Levites, even the principal fathers over against their younger brethren. Chapter 25. Moreover, David and the captains of the host separated to the service of the sons of Asaph, and of Heman, and of Jeduthun, who should prophesy with harps, with psalteries, and with cymbals, and the number of the workmen according to their service was: of the sons of Asaph, Zachur, and Joseph, and Nethaniah, and Asarelah, the sons of Asaph under the hands of Asaph, which prophesied according to the order of the king. Of Jeduthun, the sons of Jeduthun, Gedaliah, and Zeri, and Shiah, Hashabiah, and Mattithiah, six, under the hands of their father Jeduthun, who prophesied with a harp, to give thanks and to praise the Lord. Of Heman, the sons of Heman, Bukiah, Mataniah, Utziel, Shavuel, and Jerimoth, Hananiah, Hanani, Iliatha, Gedalti, and Romamtiezer, Joshbekishah, Malatai, Hadir, and Mahachioth, all these were the sons of Heman the king's seer in the words of God, to lift up the horn. And God gave to Heman 14 sons and 3 daughters. All these were under the hands of their father for song in the house of the Lord, with cymbals, psalteries, and harps, for the service of the house of God, according to the king's order to Asaph, Jeduthun, and Heman. So the number of them, with their brethren that were instructed in the songs of the Lord, even all that were cunning, was 288. And they cast lots, ward against ward, as well the small as the great, the teacher as the scholar. Now the first lot came forth for Asaph to Joseph, the second to Gedaliah, who with his brethren and sons were 12, the third to Zachur, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the fourth to Isri, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the fifth to Nethaniah, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the sixth to Bukiah, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the seventh to Jesherelah, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the eighth to Jeshiah, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the ninth to Mataniah, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the tenth to Shimei, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 11th to Azareel, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 12th to Hashabia, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 13th to Shubael, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 14th to Mattithiah, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 15th to Jeremoth, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 16th to Hananiah, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 17th to Josh-Bekishah, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 18th to Hanani, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 19th to Malachi, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 20th to Eliatha, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 1 and 20th to Hadir, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 2 and 20th to Gedalti, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 3 and 20th to Mahachioth, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12, the 4 and 20th to Romamtiezer, he, his sons, and his brethren, were 12. Chapter 26 Concerning the divisions of the porters, of the Korites was Meshelemiah the son of Koret, of the sons of Asaph. And the sons of Meshelemiah were, Zechariah the firstborn, Jediel the second, Zebadiah the third, Jathniel the fourth, Elam the fifth, Jehohanan the sixth, Elioena the seventh. Moreover the sons of Obed-Edom were, Shemaiah the firstborn, Jehozabad the second, Joe the third, and Sakar the fourth, and Nethaneel the fifth, Emiel the sixth, Issachar the seventh, Pultai the eighth, for God blessed him. Also unto Shemaiah his son were sons born, that ruled throughout the house of their father, for they were mighty men of valor. The sons of Shemaiah, Othni and Rephael and Obed, Elzabad, whose brethren were strong men, Elihu and Samachia. All these of the sons of Obed-Edom, they and their sons and their brethren, able men for strength for the service, were 62 of Obed-Edom. And Meshelemiah had sons and brethren, strong men, 18. Also Hosat, of the children of Merari, had sons, Simri the chief, for though he was not the firstborn, yet his father made him the chief. Hilkiah the second, Tibaliah the third, Zechariah the fourth, all the sons and brethren of Hosat were 13. Among these were the divisions of the porters, even among the chief men, having wards one against another, to minister in the house of the Lord. And they cast lots, as well the small as the great, according to the house of their fathers, for every gate. And the lot eastward fell to Shelemiah. Then for Zechariah his son, a wise counselor, they cast lots, and his lot came out northward. To Obed-Edom southward, and to his sons the house of Ashupim. To Shupim and Hosah the lot came forth westward, with the gate Sheleshet, by the causeway of the going up, ward against ward. Eastward were 6 Levites, northward 4 a day, southward 4 a day, and toward Ashupim 2 and 2. At Parber westward, 4 at the causeway, and 2 at Parber. These are the divisions of the porters among the sons of Koret, and among the sons of Merari. And of the Levites, Ahijah was over the treasures of the house of God, and over the treasures of the dedicated things. As concerning the sons of Laden, the sons of the Gershonite Laden, chief fathers, even of Laden the Gershonite, were Jehieli. The sons of Jehieli, Zetham, and Joel his brother, which were over the treasures of the house of the Lord. Of the Amramites, and the Azarites, the Hebronites, and the Utsilites, and Shavuel the son of Gershom, the son of Moses, was ruler of the treasures. And his brethren by Elizur, Rehabiah his son, and Shiah his son, and Joram his son, and Zikri his son, and Shalamith his son. Which Shalamith and his brethren were over all the treasures of the dedicated things, which David the king, and the chief fathers, the captains over thousands and hundreds, and the captains of the host, had dedicated. Out of the spoils won in battles did they dedicate to maintain the house of the Lord. And all that Samuel the seer, and Saul the son of Kish, and Abner the son of Ney, and Joab the son of Zeruiah, had dedicated, and whosoever had dedicated anything, it was under the hand of Shalomith, and of his brethren. Of the Azarites, Chenaniah and his sons were for the outward business over Israel, for officers and judges. And of the Hebronites, Hashabiah and his brethren, men of valor, 1,700, were officers among them of Israel on this side Jordan westward in all the business of the Lord, and in the service of the king. Among the Hebronites was Jerijah the chief, even among the Hebronites, according to the generations of his fathers. In the 40th year of the reign of David they were sought for, and there were found among them mighty men of valor at Jazer of Gilead. And his brethren, men of valor, were 2,700 chief fathers, whom King David made rulers over the Reubenites, the Gadites, and the half-tribe of Manasseh, for every matter pertaining to God, and affairs of the king. Chapter 27. Now the children of Israel after their number, to wit, the chief fathers and captains of thousands and hundreds, and their officers that served the king in any matter of the courses, which came in and went out month by month throughout all the months of the year, of every course were 24,000. Over the first course for the first month was Jashobeam the son of Zabdiel, and in his course were 24,000. Of the children of Perez was the chief of all the captains of the host for the first month. And over the course of the second month was Dodai an Ahohite, and of his course was Mikloth also the ruler, in his course likewise were 24,000. The third captain of the host for the third month was Benaiah the son of Jehoiada, a chief priest, and in his course were 24,000. This is that Benaiah, who was mighty among the 30, and above the 30, and in his course was Ammi-Zabit his son. The fourth captain for the fourth month was Asahel the brother of Joab, and Zebadiah his son after him, and in his course were 24,000. The fifth captain for the fifth month was Shamhuth the Israelite, and in his course were 24,000. The sixth captain for the sixth month was Ira the son of Ikish the Tekoite, and in his course were 24,000. The seventh captain for the seventh month was Helez the Pelonite, of the children of Ephraim, and in his course were 24,000. The eighth captain for the eighth month was Sabike the Hushathite, of the Zaraites, and in his course were 24,000. The ninth captain for the ninth month was Abizar the Anidothite, of the Benjamites, and in his course were 24,000. The tenth captain for the tenth month was Maharai the Netophathite, of the Zaraites, and in his course were 24,000. The eleventh captain for the eleventh month was Benaiah the Pirathonite, of the children of Ephraim, and in his course were 24,000. The twelfth captain for the twelfth month was Heldai the Netophathite, of Othniel, and in his course were 24,000. Furthermore over the tribes of Israel, the ruler of the Reubenites was Elizur the son of Zikri, of the Simeonites, Shephishah the son of Macha, of the Levites, Hashabiah the son of Kemuel, of the Aaronites, Zadok, of Judah, Elihu, one of the brethren of David, of Issachar, Omri the son of Michael, of Zebulun, Ishmaiah the son of Obadiah, of Naphtali, Jerimoth the son of Azriel, of the children of Ephraim, Hashiah the son of Azachiah, of the half-tribe of Manasseh, Joel the son of Pedaiah. Of the half-tribe of Manasseh in Gilead, Iddo the son of Zechariah, of Benjamin, Jasiel the son of Abner, of Dan, Azareel the son of Jeroham. These were the princes of the tribes of Israel. But David took not the number of them from 20 years old and under, because the Lord had said he would increase Israel like to the stars of the heavens. Joab the son of Zeruiah began to number, but he finished not, because there fell wrath for it against Israel, neither was the number put in the account of the Chronicles of King David. And over the king's treasures was Azmaveth the son of Adiel, and over the storehouses in the fields, in the cities, and in the villages, and in the castles, was Jehonathan the son of Uzziah, and over them that did the work of the field for tillage of the ground was Ezri the son of Kelub, and over the vineyards was Shimei the Ramathite, over the increase of the vineyards for the wine cellars was Zabdi the Shipthmite, and over the olive trees and the sycamore trees that were in the low plains was Baal-Hanan the Gedrite, and over the cellars of oil was Joash, and over the herds that fed in Sharon was Shitrai the Sharonite, and over the herds that were in the valleys was Shaphat the son of Adlai, over the camels also was Obal the Ishmaelite, and over the asses was Jedeah the Moronathite, and over the flocks was Jaziz the Hagrite. All these were the rulers of the substance which was King David's. Also Jonathan David's uncle was a counselor, a wise man, and a scribe, and Jehiel the son of Hachmoni was with the king's sons, and Ahithophel was the king's counselor, and Hushai the Archite was the king's companion, and after Ahithophel was Jehoiada the son of Benaiah and Abiathar, and the general of the king's army was Joab. Chapter 28 And David assembled all the princes of Israel, the princes of the tribes, and the captains of the companies that ministered to the king by course, and the captains over the thousands, and captains over the hundreds, and the stewards over all the substance and possession of the king, and of his sons, with the officers, and with the mighty men, and with all the valiant men, unto Jerusalem. Then David the king stood up upon his feet, and said, Hear me, my brethren, and my people, as for me, I had in mine heart to build an house of rest for the ark of the covenant of the Lord, and for the footstool of our God, and had made ready for the building, but God said unto me, Thou shalt not build an house for my name, because thou hast been a man of war, and hast shed blood. Howbeit the Lord God of Israel chose me before all the house of my father to be king over Israel for ever, for he hath chosen Judah to be the ruler, and of the house of Judah, the house of my father, and among the sons of my father he liked me to make me king over all Israel, and of all my sons, for the Lord hath given me many sons, he hath chosen Solomon my son to sit upon the throne of the kingdom of the Lord over Israel. And he said unto me, Solomon thy son, he shall build my house and my courts, for I have chosen him to be my son, and I will be his father. Moreover I will establish his kingdom for ever, if he be constant to do my commandments and my judgments, as at this day. Now therefore in the sight of all Israel the congregation of the Lord, and in the audience of our God, keep and seek for all the commandments of the Lord your God, that ye may possess this good land, and leave it for an inheritance for your children after you for ever. And thou, Solomon my son, know thou the God of thy father, and serve him with a perfect heart and with a willing mind, for the Lord searcheth all hearts, and understandeth all the imaginations of the thoughts. If thou seek him, he will be found of thee, but if thou forsake him, he will cast thee off for ever. Take heed now, for the Lord hath chosen thee to build an house for the sanctuary, be strong, and do it. Then David gave to Solomon his son the pattern of the porch, and of the houses thereof, and of the treasuries thereof, and of the upper chambers thereof, and of the inner parlors thereof, and of the place of the mercy seat, and the pattern of all that he had by the Spirit, of the courts of the house of the Lord, and of all the chambers round about, of the treasuries of the house of God, and of the treasuries of the dedicated things, also for the courses of the priests and the Levites, and for all the work of the service of the house of the Lord, and for all the vessels of service in the house of the Lord. He gave of gold by weight 4 things of gold, for all instruments of all manner of service, silver also for all instruments of silver by weight, for all instruments of every kind of service, even the weight for the candlesticks of gold, and for their lamps of gold, by weight for every candlestick, and for the lamps thereof, and for the candlesticks of silver by weight, both for the candlestick, and also for the lamps thereof, according to the use of every candlestick. And by weight he gave gold for the tables of showbread, for every table, and likewise silver for the tables of silver, also pure gold for the flesh hooks, and the bowls, and the cups, and for the golden basins he gave gold by weight for every basin, and likewise silver by weight for every basin of silver, and for the altar of incense refined gold by weight, and gold for the pattern of the chariot of the cherubims, that spread out their wings, and covered the ark of the covenant of the Lord. All this, said David, the Lord made me understand in writing by his hand upon me, even all the works of this pattern. And David said to Solomon his son, Be strong and of good courage, and do it, fear not, nor be dismayed, for the Lord God, even my God, will be with thee, he will not fail thee, nor forsake thee, until thou hast finished all the work for the service of the house of the Lord. And, behold, the courses of the priests and the Levites, even they shall be with thee for all the service of the house of God, and there shall be with thee for all manner of workmanship every willing skillful man, for any manner of service, also the princes and all the people will be holy at thy commandment. Chapter 29. Furthermore David the king said unto all the congregation, Solomon my son, whom alone God hath chosen, is yet young and tender, and the work is great, for the palace is not for man, but for the Lord God. Now I have prepared with all my might for the house of my God the gold for things to be made of gold, and the silver for things of silver, and the brass for things of brass, the iron for things of iron, and wood for things of wood, onyx stones, and stones to be set, glistering stones, and of divers colors, and all manner of precious stones, and marble stones in abundance. Moreover, because I have set my affection to the house of my God, I have of mine own proper good, of gold and silver, which I have given to the house of my God, over and above all that I have prepared for the holy house, even 3,000 talents of gold, of the gold of Ophir, and 7,000 talents of refined silver, to overlay the walls of the houses withal, the gold for things of gold, and the silver for things of silver, and for all manner of work to be made by the hands of artificers. And who then is willing to consecrate his service this day unto the Lord? Then the chief of the fathers and princes of the tribes of Israel, and the captains of thousands and of hundreds, with the rulers of the king's work, offered willingly, and gave for the service of the house of God of gold 5,000 talents and 10,000 drams, and of silver 10,000 talents, and of brass 18,000 talents, and 100,000 talents of iron. And they with whom precious stones were found gave them to the treasure of the house of the Lord, by the hand of Jehiel the Gershonite. Then the people rejoiced, for that they offered willingly, because with perfect heart they offered willingly to the Lord, and David the king also rejoiced with great joy. Wherefore David blessed the Lord before all the congregation, and David said, Blessed be thou, Lord God of Israel our Father, for ever and ever. Thine, O Lord, is the greatness, and the power, and the glory, and the victory, and the majesty, for all that is in the heaven and in the earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Lord, and thou art exalted as head above all. Both riches and honor come of thee, and thou reignest over all, and in thine hand is power and might, and in thine hand it is to make great, and to give strength unto all. Now therefore, our God, we thank thee, and praise thy glorious name. But who am I, and what is my people, that we should be able to offer so willingly after this sort? For all things come of thee, and of thine own have we given thee. For we are strangers before thee, and sojourners, as were all our fathers, our days on the earth are as a shadow, and there is none abiding. O Lord our God, all this store that we have prepared to build thee an house for thine holy name cometh of thine hand, and is all thine own. I know also, my God, that thou treest the heart, and hast pleasure in uprightness. As for me, in the uprightness of mine heart I have willingly offered all these things, and now have I seen with joy thy people, which are present here, to offer willingly unto thee. O Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, our fathers, keep this forever in the imagination of the thoughts of the heart of thy people, and prepare their heart unto thee, and give unto Solomon my son a perfect heart, to keep thy commandments, thy testimonies, and thy statutes, and to do all these things, and to build the palace, for the which I have made provision. And David said to all the congregation, Now bless the Lord your God. And all the congregation blessed the Lord God of their fathers, and bowed down their heads, and worshipped the Lord, and the king. And they sacrificed sacrifices unto the Lord, and offered burnt offerings unto the Lord, on the morrow after that day, even 1,000 bullocks, 1,000 rams, and 1,000 lambs, with their drink offerings, and sacrifices in abundance for all Israel, and did eat and drink before the Lord on that day with great gladness. And they made Solomon the son of David king the second time, and anointed him unto the Lord to be the chief governor, and Zadok to be priest. Then Solomon sat on the throne of the Lord as king instead of David his father, and prospered, and all Israel obeyed him. And all the princes, and the mighty men, and all the sons likewise of King David, submitted themselves unto Solomon the king. And the Lord magnified Solomon exceedingly in the sight of all Israel, and bestowed upon him such royal majesty as had not been on any king before him in Israel. Thus David the son of Jesse reigned over all Israel. And the time that he reigned over Israel was 40 years, 7 years reigned he in Hebron, and 33 years reigned he in Jerusalem. And he died in a good old age, full of days, riches, and honor, and Solomon his son reigned in his stead. Now the acts of David the king, first and last, behold, they are written in the book of Samuel the seer, and in the book of Nathan the prophet, and in the book of Gad the seer, with all his reign and his might, and the times that went over him, and over Israel, and over all the kingdoms of the countries.